This is how I do my rinseless wash. I have my Ryobi Easy Spray with the attachment for the 1 gallon. Converted it to metal quick connects. That one too. Just snaps on like that. There's roughly about 1 gallon of filtered water and about 2 gallons of filtered water here. I like this one because it's, you can see the level of the water. Okay. I have 2 sponges from ONR, the big red sponge and the blue sponge. What I use for the red sponge is for the body, and this one is for the wheels and tires. I have 2 sizes of ONR, don't ask me why. So we're gonna measure out. There's the level is at 1 gallon or 1 ounce, so we just squeeze the bottle. All right, and until it reaches that, it should self-level. And just open this and pour 1 ounce. Should be 1 ounce to 2 gallons. There you go. I lowered it to 1/2 ounce. Because that's for the 1 ounce bottle here. Okay, you got 1/2 ounce. All right, I got all my stuff ready. So you can get an idea of how dirty this is. I hope you can see this. Okay, so there it is. I'm gonna try to record this from start to finish. I want to see how long it takes. Blow dryer, pressure washer, sponges, and then dry it with a towel. Let's see how long this takes. So at this point, I don't know how long that took until I get into editing, but here it is. After that process, it's not the best way, but that's just how I do it. You know, there are a lot of different ways out there. Okay, we're gonna use Opti-Seal to finish up our rinseless wash, I guess. My car is already coated with graphene, so this will just go on top of it and help prolong it. Should just spray one, spray into this sponge and go until you feel that it's getting dry. But since this is a new sponge, I'm going to spray two just to get it saturated or primed. All right.
Thank you.
All right, Opti-Seal. There you go. Start to finish. Almost start to finish. So the Opti-Seal does leave a little residue like this one right here. If you over apply it, all you gotta do is wipe it. And it's gone. Gotta go around the car. Found another one right there. 2, 3, 4. Gone. Now I don't know like how long you can wait and still remove it, you know, like once it's baked on there. I don't know if it's like a ceramic or a graphene coating where if you leave high spots you're toast, but so far these high spots are going away with 3 or 4 passes. And to show you just how easy this is coming off, I'm using my left hand because my right hand's holding the camera. So I'm not even using my dominant hand and it's still coming off easy. So yeah, after you apply this stuff, you just have to go around the vehicle and wipe off any excess. There it is, guys. That's got graphene underneath that. I did an ONR rinseless wash and then an Opti-Seal. I did not dry the rims or the tires. I didn't touch it after the blue sponge. I just left it on there. These tires do have the Dura coating. Dura dressing on them, which lasts a few months. So there you go. Touching it, feeling it, I would say it's not as smooth as graphene underneath it. You know, it doesn't have that. It's a little grabby, to be honest. Just a little bit, not too much. But if you compare that to graphene and ceramics, this one's not as smooth. I'm trying to let that go. It's not going. All right, there it is.